Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video we are going to do this holy nail. This is where, you know, like when you go to a funeral and you have those sad songs, this is what needs to be playing over now.
Yeah, but you do have clients that come to you with really chewed, bitten nails in the salon, and you think, some people turn them away.
Yeah.
So this is a challenge.
It's a challenge for you,
but I mean.
Oh, it's a challenge.
Really?
A little bit. So, but this will be a good video for everybody to see, and obviously good for you guys who are on the Back to Basics training to see. And this is something that we've never done on the Back to Basics training before, because we've never had somebody with such a chewed nail. So thank you so much, Cheryl, for coming along today with your big chewed nail. How lucky are we?
Yes.
So yeah, I want to show you this nail in great detail, because there is actually a nail on there. I know some of you might be thinking, well, is there a nail? The nail actually runs to here. These have been peeled and picked. And I can feel that this is very hard. It's all keratinized. Keratinized cells. Sorry, is that a little bit? Is that a little bit tender?
Just there, like.
The fresh peeling.
Yeah, on the motorway up
here. Yeah. So on the motorway, Cheryl did have another go at peeling and picking of the nail. Which, to be honest with you, it is classed as self-harming.
We've talked about it in the previous video where you told us how you used the compass.
I used the compass in class and pick a hole there and then pull the nail out on the half nail. That's how I got into nails. I had to do something.
Like, I can't keep doing this to myself.
Yeah. So when I had a set of nails, and I thought, you know, I'm going to learn how to do that.
Yeah, looks good, that. Mm. So, some people would turn people away.
Yeah.
Fortunate enough, Cheryl is an award-winning nail technician. Just point that out there, Cheryl Walker. So I feel really comfortable putting a nail on here. I am comfortable with putting that. Some people might be thinking, oh my God, what are you doing here? You still should not be doing that. I don't know why I'm doing it in American accent, but.
Because they like to have a whinge.
So yeah, we're going to build up an acrylic nail extension onto this nail. You are going to be absolutely fine with it, because you want this done, don't you? You would prefer to have this done, and you've actually done this before and grown it out underneath the acrylic or gel before. So we're really safe in doing this. I am going to prep a little bit around the skin. Now, I'm more of a skin picker than a nail chewer or a nail peeler. When I've got no nails on, I definitely do have a bit of a chew. So I'm feeling you right now. So I'm going round with the cuticle bit just to clean out that area from any non-living tissue. Don't think there's much living tissue though, because Cheryl's picked it off. We're going to come around here. So we're going from 11 o'clock and we are wazzing all the way around. So this is your most sensitive part, isn't it? This bit here. I'm going to be careful.
No, it doesn't. Yeah.
Okay. You all right?
Yeah.
Was it close?
No, it's all right.
All right, okay. And then we're going to take this proximal fold bit and just wazz that around as well.
What kind of speed would you say is best to use that
at? Between 10 and 12, if you've got a dial that tells you that. This one doesn't. So I'll go between 10 and 12. between sort of 10 to 5 to, what about the clocks? So, you will have an e-file that probably goes between 250,000 revs per minute, not 200, but 25,000 revs, rotations, yeah? Or 30,000 rotations, yeah? Would you ever use your e-file like that?
No.
Never. It may go that fast, but it doesn't mean you have to use it that fast. Because your car may go at 140 miles per hour. Would you ever drive it at that? Would your car last you very long if you drove it at that speed all the time? It wouldn't, so that's why you would never use your e-file all that way. So we're just exfoliating at the minute. And I can actually use this bit to abrase the nail a little bit to remove the surface shine. If I go over with a nail file, I'm gonna want to keep filing because I've, let me show you what I mean. Because there's so many dips, we get a 240 grit file and we file, it's actually only hitting here and here, yeah, all those raised sections, and you're tempted to just keep filing until you make it all smooth, but then you're just thinning the nail out and damaging it even more. So using an abrasive bit that is small, you know, it could be a ball bit, it could be, you know, a shape like this, but as long as it's abrasive, you can quite controlled go over that. You're a lot more controlled doing it like this way. Right, so.
I'm scared.
So we're going to do a ballerina.
Gonna hurt.
Nah, it's not going to hurt.
Oh, you're feeling for her.
Aww.
Aww. Lovely, Sarah.
Even if it did hurt, I'd still get her to put one on.
I know.
No pain, no gain. Right, so I'm going to close this form at the end, and this is what we're going to do. We're going to get it as close as we can to the nail. We could, I feel like I really want
to
go.
Under there.
I want to go here. But we're slightly exposing the skin to a lot of acrylic. What, and just go like this?
Just do it.
I think I need like a Cheryl face cam here, just for the lols.
Right, when I'm looking at this, I am going to cut. I'm not going to cut this area because that's just absolutely pointless, because I'm never going to stick it under that nail. I just want to release a bit of pressure from the side. Yeah, we're just going to snip.
Nothing
gets to look at
a form being cut again the same.
Yeah. Just releasing a bit of pressure.
Just going to think of everything.
Put a tiny bit more off there. Don't want that bit sticking up. And a little bit more there.
So in like salon world, obviously,
yeah.
Would you expect, like, if a client come to you with a nail like that, really?
Would you do it for them?
I mean, realistically.
Realistically, if you know that client really well, and they'll sign a disc you know, a disclosure form that'll say, disclaimer form that'll say that they are taking it on themselves. And yeah.
I mean, would you turn around and tell them that obviously they may not, they might need their maintenance more often?
Exactly.
Yeah.
That is exactly what you would have to do. So with this, Cheryl's going to have to make sure she doesn't knock it, she doesn't put no pressure on it. She'll need to make sure that she's going to fill it in a couple of weeks' time. She might even have to fill it after a week, because when you have a damaged nail, it tends to grow a lot faster.
Yeah.
So even if a week's time, if it starts to have that growth and it looks like a 2 week fill, you're gonna have to fill it. And she can fill it because she's, you know, award winning, don't they? But yeah, if somebody came in the salon, I think you would have to have quite a good relationship with that client to know that it's sort of on their head. It's completely up to them. If it was a new client coming in, there's no way I would do it.
I've got one client, she does bite the hell out of them, and I know for a while that she had, if she had nails on, it would probably stop her from biting the hell
even
out of
putting
them.
Short nails on. I had a client years ago that had literally about that much nail.
I've got a client like that.
Yeah? And I put nails on her just to the end of her finger. And we just did like a lovely little skinny French, yeah? And nails looked lovely. It was only right to the end of her finger. Kept maintaining every 2 weeks, filling, every 2 weeks, taking down the length, filling it, taking down the length, filling it, taking down the length, until her nail had grown all the way to the end and her actual nail plate had reattached to her nail bed, and she actually had lovely long nail beds. And it was just, it's part of like, what's the word? Not
rehab.
Reconstruction.
Rehab.
Rehab, I suppose, yeah? No. No. No.
Therapy.
No, I've said it before. Recovery. Nails, like nails in recovery. That's what it is. Yeah? So they are recovering from trauma. Whether that is you slammed it in a door, you've self-mutilated it, you know.
It's like when they crack and it's cracked.
Yeah.
The fractures along. We do one or two of them, don't we?
Yeah, so if they've cracked their own natural nail as well. Putting acrylic on acts like a bandage and supports it far more than a, you know, a bandage would, or a plaster, or a band-aid. That makes sense?
Yeah.
Awesome. Thank you. So, what I'm going to do now is, let me just check this, that is fine. We are going to put on dehydrator, so don't forget you're still going to dehydrate.
Whatever's left on the nail.
Yep, just on that natural nail. And then we're going to do the same with the primer. You don't want to put the primer on any of the skin that's exposed. You're going to put it just on that natural nail. So you can see the nail really well now. Yeah, at least it's not gel. Do not do it in gel.
It nearly was gel. Nearly was.
Was it?
Yeah.
Oh, not good. That'll burn. Burning.
Yeah, I was going to.
You thought best not. Yeah. So I'm coming quite low in the powder. Still don't think that's big enough. Let me get a lot of liquid in my brush. And then come quite low again. 1, 2, 3. Onto the form. And I'm going to build this in layers. And I'm going to build it in layers more so I can really monitor what I'm doing. So, we're going to connect and go quite thin. And we're going to pat, press and pull. Now, if I work in layers rather than big beads, I will reduce the amount of heat that will come from the acrylic when it starts to polymerize. The reason to do that is because of the damage and the exposed skin. So we're going again and we're layering. but still working from that free edge, you know, we're not working from the cuticle down, then we're going to come here, and I'm still going to layer. So they're more medium beads than, you know, they don't want them too big. So you're still layering. I went in with a big bead and created sort of 3/4 of the nail. There would be a lot of heat that Cheryl would feel. And not that that would damage the nail, but it would cause discomfort to my poor friend. Do you feel anything?
No.
Feeling good?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to layer in that middle section again. Right, let's do this cuticle area. And a tiny bit there just to fill anything. Clean my brush, make sure it's nice and clean before I leave it on the side. Lovely jubbly. We can take that off. So, the form fit was the same as your stiletto. Only difference being the longest point of the nail that you're creating isn't going to be a super point. So you don't need to close it, do you? So with this one, we closed down the form all the way, didn't we? To get that 0 point. Whereas this, it's still open. It's not open, but it's curved. Yeah? So you need to think about the length that it's going to. That makes sense? Right, let's give it a file. Normal filing routine. I am going to support, really concentrate on supporting that nail. It's a long nail. It needs lots of support. Get wild cards, balloons, things like that. Deepest sympathy.
Ooh, feel that. No, this vice. You know this vice here? You know your vice? That you have wrist. Yeah. That's what I feel.
Okay. I can't help it.
Just do it.
Every time she's like, you don't need to hold my finger that hard.
You're going to get carpal tunnel.
Why have I not got it already? I'm 41. Come on now. Should
that's
be
not old.
Now. That's no. Just not old. It's not old enough. But yeah, I probably will get that one if I carry on. I did make conscious effort to try and be more gentle with the grip. But it's like, I'm not.
When you remember there's nothing here and you're doing that.
Okay.
Don't get that camera on me, I'm telling you. Put my fist there.
In that sort of case, would it not be better to e-file so that there's not as much pressure?
Well, what would you e-file when you file that?
Just to like to.
There's not a lot, is there, to file? We can do. Would you like to see how that feels?
I won't feel it, I know that, but.
Let's give it a go.
No, it makes no difference.
No.
No, the vice.
No difference. So it's just all down to Kirsty's grip.
Yeah, it's right. Kirsty's grip. You can see that shade of purple coming there. Yeah. Right
there. They've always said I've had a good grip.
Is that why you can't keep
your voice out?
Gentle. All done now, we just got to top coat it. That's all we've got to do. It's nearly over. But on a serious note, how does it feel?
I better not whack it, put it that way.
Yeah.
Yeah. Should have done a short almond nail. You know, be realistic. So the nail bot is not going to come in and have an hour that length, are they?
Now, she says. Now.
And you're not taking it off either?
No.
That'll be
fine. Yeah, so if it was anybody that walked in the salon, I would definitely do like I did on that other client, just take it to the end of the finger, a very small nail extension, and let it grow out. However, Cheryl's a little bit different. She's very special. So I'm going to finish off with a little bit of cuticle oil. Oh, replenish all the chewage.
Can you feel the heat?
No.
No, fingers hot.
It's because it's had a lot of rubbing and messing around, and the blood is whizzing around it. Now guys, hope you've enjoyed this video. Please take on all the advice that I have given you today and make things realistic when somebody walks in the salon with this kind of nail trauma. Don't be going creating nails this long on people that you are not confident with or do not know extremely well. Sorry. Everything I've used today will be listed below. See you in the next video. Bye bye.